Welcome back. I'm glad you're here to coin a phrase nobody has ever written. It is the best of times. It is the worst of times. The best part is the fact that WSU is one win away from its first Pac-12 North title and is currently No. 14 in the CFP rankings. The worst part is the fact that the GambeTron is playing more like the StagnantO than the Speed, especially in conference games. This should come as no surprise, since we haven't been able to crack the Pac-12 cipher lock all season. That's mostly our own fault, as we've wantonly ignored trends that are right in front of us, such as the taking the home team on Friday night, no matter what. The only time that worked out was when we took Cal 14. Kinda wish that was the only one we'd lost anyhow. Let's take a look back. Why, I'm a genius, hey, so, how about them Trojans? Covered by a whopping half a point, never a doubt, especially with Colorado inside the five late in the game, looking for a meaningless TD elsewhere. As you'll see below, we hit on 3 of 4 early games. Not bad. Texas A&M isn't very good, but whoa boy, has New Mexico ever fallen off a cliff. As soon as that Oklahoma line dipped below 7, it was 7.5 for much of the week. It was the perfect time to pounce. The GambleTron has already taken 2 kicks to the pills, and Saturday HASNT even started. Don't count the UW loss because screw them. Let's start the chase. $220 on all Gamecocks 4.5 Rutgers 3-1 MTSU 1-5 Ole Miss 22. See you later, when these all go down in flames. PJ Kendall airplane coffin at death be 105. November 11, 2017 should have been 40, at which point we'd have packed it in. But no, one loss made us go back to the well. GambleTron was a razor's edge from 40 on the early games. Let's go with the following to continue the chase, all for $220. FIU 10 Texas AM 17.5 ND 3 Oklahoma 6.5 PJ Kendall airplane coffin at death be 105. November 11, 2017 could have been worse. Why, I'm an idiot. Look, if Kyle Whittingham had sent me a text telling me they'd turn the ball over 7 times, my pick probably would have been different. I see you, Stanford. Playing possum for much of the season, only to pounce and make WSU fans happy. But did you have to allow that last 2 count that exceeded the total? That wasn't very nice. Congratulations to the Beavers for figuring out the "this game was never competitive but we still covered the spread" formula. Great job. Always great when a team ASU rushes for 290 and loses. Somebody show Todd Graham the door. Special thanks to Coastal Carolina for scoring an inconsequential 2 count in the last couple minutes to get within 14. Did I mention the line was 15? Oh, you can see IT up there. Well, I'm going to yell about IT anyway. Took a flyer on FIU, thinking they could beat a team that lost 60 the week prior. Never take flyers, kids. And you won't believe this, but Notre Dame didn't live up to the hype. I know, I'm stunned too. Last week 88 season total 59,615, cash balance $1,930. Sad face, but wait, this week is already off to a good start, thanks to Terry Bowden and his interesting hair color. The GambleTron is starting the pain early this week, because why not? $220 on Akron 14.5 PJ Kendall airplane coffin at death be 105. November 15, 2017 one outright winner, Bobcat dinner. ASU 7,110 at OSU 7,110. Okay, Beavs. You totally owe me one after being non-competitive yet doing just enough to cover by 1 damn point last week. Additionally, I'm tired of going against home underdogs. Additionally, I get to root against Todd Graham. The pick $110 on OSU Arizona at Oregon. Pick him 110. Will he, or won't he? Am I talking about Justin Herbert playing? Am I talking about Willie Taggart going to Florida? Am I talking about Khalil Tate busting another 70-yard run? All are possible. I want Arizona to lose for WSU bowl reasons, and I think Herbert plays. Plus, like most Pac-12 teams, Arizona isn't as good on the road. The pick $110 on Oregon. Cal 16,110 at Stanford 16,110. Speaking of teams who stink on the road and play well at home, hey there, Cal. I get the feeling that David Shaw asked Bryce Love to leave it all on the field last week in exchange for resting him a bit in this game. The only hope is a backdoor cover, and I think okay hope, okay pray Cal gets a late score. The pick $110 on Cal UCLA 15.5110 at USC 15.5110. USC has the Pac-12 title game in its sights. UCLA has the offseason in its sights. UCLA is historically bad at rushing defense. Ronald Jones is a person who exists in the USC backfield who should run a 5K on Saturday. I'd take USC minus 3 2 counts in this game. In other words, they'll kick a late field goal to win. The pick $220 on Tommy and the Trojans, Utah, 17110 at Washington, 17110 Angry Huskies. Incompetent Utes. Not a good combo if you're hoping for a Utah win here. The pick $110 on Washington, Purdue, 7.5110 at Iowa, 7.5110 Iowa has been a bit up and down. First they napalm Ohio State, then they get curb stomped at Wisconsin. Purdue seems like a good cure for what ails such things. The pick $110 on Iowa, Virginia, 20110 at Miami, 20,110. You'd think I'd learn a lesson not to fade Miami after what happened these last 2 weeks. But in order to learn a lesson, one must be somewhat intelligent. You won't find that here. Does Miami ever play on the road? They haven't lately. What makes this game different is that they're playing at noon, in front of what will surely be fewer people, and they'll probably be sleepwalking. The pick $110 on UVA, Florida International, 14,110 at Florida Atlantic, 14,110, making this pick for two reasons. First, the Owls have been lighting teams on fire. Second, I'm pissed at FIU for laying that egg last week. That second one is a cardinal sin of gambling. Ask me if I care. Wait, don't, because I don't. The pick $330 on FLAATL, go Cougs.